Hi everybody. So now that we have finished with the theoretical aspect or the theory of meeting procedures, we need to look at how to draw up the documentation that goes with every meeting. So we said that every private meeting has to when a private meeting is going to happen, members have to receive an invitation in the form of a notice. And attached to this notice, usually you would have the agenda, but that is for the next lesson. So for now, let's see how to do the notice of a meeting. The notice is a notification. It is a letter that tells you when that a meeting will take place. And it will contain the following information: the venue, that is where the meeting will take place, the date on which day the meeting will take place, the time, the exact time a meeting will take place, as well as the type of meeting. Is it a general meeting, a special meeting, or whatever? So you're going to indicate that in your notice. The notice should be sent to everybody who's eligible to attend or should attend. So if it's a staff meeting, the notice goes to every single staff member. And if it is a special committee meeting or a committee meeting, it goes to every committee member. So a notice must be sent to everyone who should attend the meeting or who belongs to the organization. And then the notice can be either formal or informal. So the difference here is that a formal meeting, you will send to your external stakeholders. That means the people who don't belong or work in the organization. An informal notice is one that's sent to the staff members, internal notification to people who are working at this organization. So there is a difference between the two notices. If you go into the Google Classroom, you will see that there are two documents that show you the different ways or two templates that show you the different types of notices. These templates, of course, you can take into your examination venue when you write paper one. You can thank me later. So let's look at how to write this thing. So when the notice is formal for external stakeholders, you are going to write the name of the organization as well as all the contact details. We are talking about phone numbers, fax numbers, email addresses, and physical addresses at the top of this page. Then you will have a formal greeting that says, "Dear member," or "Dear Mr." if you have all their names and it's not too many people. So it will be relatively formal because remember you are speaking to somebody outside your organization now. The subject heading, so which is normally notice of a meeting, will be in capital letters. Always in capital letters, otherwise in the exam year, you lose a mark for format. So please always in capital letters. And the general rule here is to keep it shorter than 7 words. You end your notice after you have told people what type of meeting and when and where and all of those things with yours faithfully or yours truly. Lately, we use kind regards, so it's not as formal, but you end this off quite formally and it is signed by the chairperson, the secretary, or the manager of the organization. Okay, so now the notice is ready to be sent out as soon as you have attached the agenda. When the letter is informal, so when it is on a memo, page, when it is for people inside the organization, there are slight differences. So first of all, you are going to the name of the organization will appear at the top. So in the workplace, you will normally have ready printed stationery, but for exam purposes, remember to put the name of the organization at the top of the page. Then you will have a to and a from, where you will clearly indicate the sender and the receivers of this message. Telephone numbers and telephone extension numbers are given. Remember, extension numbers are given because this is internal communication. It happens inside the organization. So it would be maybe a personal cell phone number or an extension number where people can reach the sender of the message. You won't have to greet. There's no salutation. It's not as formal, remember. And then the subject heading, notice of a meeting, normally, would again be given in capital letters. And again, a rule of thumb, no more than 7 words. Okay. And then there will be no formal ending. The secretary or the person who sends out the notice, the person who is the sender, will just initial at the end. And to initial means it's your signature, but not the full surname, just the first letter of your name and the first letter of your surname. And there you would have initialed, and that is your notice. It's as easy as that. So a typical notice will read as follows. Please note that the type of meeting, you add the type of meeting, will take place in venue on the date and time. Okay, this is now when you've added all the other garnishes of the formal or the informal meeting as shown in the previous slide. If it's, or you could write, notice is hereby given. This is a sort of older type of writing, but it is still quite used quite often, so you could use this one as well. So now if you go to the Google Classroom, you will see that there are, like I said, templates that shows you how, well, it shows you exactly how to write a notice, and you can print it out and you can take it into your paper one examination, and I'm hoping that it will be of great help to you. So this Google Classroom, you go to your browser and you type in classroom.google.com. And when it asks for, you click on join class, where it asks for a code, you put in the code NWUSR3W. Or you can email me, yevkester@gmail.com. I am available to answer questions whenever you want to. I do check my email quite often. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope, really, really hope that this is helpful to you. Until next time, bye.